Hey, I'm Mike Backrell. Today we're going to take a look at three really simple, really hip Grant Green 2-5 lines. Let's take a look. This first line is over a 2-5 in the key of C. So we got D minor 7, G 7, C major 7. So we start here on C, which is the flat 7 of the D minor chord, all with our pinky. And then we walk down to G. And then from there we go to E, F, and we jump up to C. There's a kind of enclosure on the F there. And then we come down on A. And we go F, D, and C, B. And so this is walking down a D minor 7 arpeggio down to the B, but you can also think of this as like a G9 shape. Charlie Christian used this shape a lot. And once he gets to that B, he resolves to C for the C major 7 chord. So here's the full line. And the rhythm there is 1, 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2, 3, 4, 1. Now for a little variation I came up with on this line, I really like the G7 portion of this line where he starts walking down, so I decided to keep walking down and land on A natural over the C major 7 chord. And then come down on F, E, D, C, E. The F resolves down to the E and the D resolves down to the C, so it kind of pulls us really strongly into C territory. So here's that full line. The second line is really cool. It's a quick 2-5 in the key of G. So we're going A minor 7, D7 to G. And it starts on the and of 4. So it starts with an upbeat into the measure. So starting on B, on the and of 4. And on beat 1, we come to C. And then we jump down to E. And we go up an E minor 7 arpeggio. E, G, B. And then we come down to B flat, F sharp, F natural, E flat, D. So the A minor portion of this is just purely within the scale. When we get to D7 here, we go into melodic minor territory. We go into the altered scale. And we hit the sharp 5, major 3rd, sharp 9, flat 9, and we resolve it to the 5th of the G major 7 chord. Now we can experiment with different positions too. So I'll move this to the key of C. So an E on the 5th fret of the 2nd string to F on the 6th fret. And I jump down to A on the 7th fret of the 4th string. And 5th fret on the 3rd and 2nd string. And I slide down to the 4th fret of the 2nd string. 4th fret of the 3rd string. Slide down to the 3rd fret of the 3rd string. 6th fret here on the 4th string, and I resolve it to the 5th of C major 7 here on the 5th fret. This third line is a 2-5 in the key of E flat major. So we got F minor 7, B flat 7, E flat major 7. So for the F minor 7 portion, we're outlining an A flat major 7 arpeggio, which is very cool. It's very colorful. So it starts here on A flat on the 11th fret of the fifth string. We go to 8th fret, we got B flat, C, E flat. And then we go on the 8th fret of the 2nd string, G, A flat, A natural, B flat. I'm picking the first note here, hammer, hammer, and then picking the ending note. Bruce Foreman would always do that because he would talk about how it gives you the sense of a crescendo during a slur like that. And so once he gets to B flat here, go to G and land on A flat. And that encloses the flat seventh of the B flat seven chord. You have G on the eighth fret here, second string, D on the seventh fret, third string, F, we land on E flat. Now we land on E flat during the B flat seven before the actual resolution. So the B flat portion of this would go like this. And then for the E flat major seven, we land on D, C, B flat, G. And you can see I'm shifting positions there. I'm shifting backwards. You could play it here. That's totally fine too. So here's the full thing. And here's the rhythm. One and two and three triplet four and one, two and three and four, one and two and three and. One of the things I love about Grant Green is how simple his lines are, but how hip they are. They are just, they sit in the groove so well, and they do exactly what they're supposed to. They outline the changes perfectly. They take you in interesting places, and they're not hard to incorporate in our playing because everything he's doing, we can see he's outlining familiar shapes. There's no crazy scale choices or anything like that. It's just pretty typical stuff, but it just sounds great. It's just really effective. And so I hope you take these lines and run with them, try them in different positions, move them through all the keys, apply them to tunes, and have a lot of fun with it. So thanks for checking out this lesson. Keep practicing. I'll see you next time.